So, having figured this out, of course, Bob and Carol are both very, very happy. Not because they've actually solved their problem, but now they know at least they can collaborate. They've basically doubled their chances. So, if any one of them finds a good algorithm for their problem, they'll know they have a good polynomial time algorithm for both of their problems. Alice also arrives to the meeting. And of course, Alice is very excited to hear about the discovery that Bob and Carol have made. So Alice, of course, is hoping that maybe she can also find a connection of her problem to Bob and Carol's problem, or at least that they can help her find a good algorithm for her problem by brainstorming. Alice explains her problem using the graph terminology as well. So Alice's problem, as you will remember, is to find a set of vertices so that all of the edges are covered in a network. Here, for example, if you take these three, then each edge has at least one endpoint in those set of green vertices here. So the input for Alice's problem is again a graph with n vertices, and the output is the smallest set of vertices such that all edges are covered. And of course, you know what I mean by covered. By covered, I mean that each edge has at least one endpoint in that set of vertices. So again, we should give that problem a name to refer to it. So just as Bob was working on click and Carol was working on independent set, we have Alice working on her problem. And since she is using the vertices to cover the edges, we'll call her problem vertex cover.